July 2nd, 2016. It's approximately 9:30 a.m. Saturday, Independence Day, or I should say non-Independence Day weekend. People gotta realize that what's going on is not isolated, and it's not something that's not important. We're surrounded by approximately, I'd say about 200 acres of Monsanto cotton. That right there on the edge of the grass is probably about 20 feet or closer to the grass. By my garden, it's about 20 feet, and then Monsanto cotton, which is one of the most heavily insecticide, poisoned, treated crop. And I show about the sunflowers on the outer edge of my garden, on the north end of my garden. Okra's been putting out quite a few pods. I mean, these things are just about waist high, roughly. They're too close together, actually. Well, this one and this one's not. Well, let me see if I can see it on here. That one and that one, there aren't. That one, but I got like four or five of them right on top of each other in the middle there. But they're putting out some good pods. Gosh. Again, it's like you think I'd learned something from last year to this year, which, you know, we're trying different things. We put up this corn here. I put up four rows of corn, then I put up five corn rows away from that because I got them too close. And then was told that they weren't going to put up corn, or they were going to put cotton and soybean in their farmland, 300 acres around us, which they did. But see, the brother, which they don't have any association with, really, put Monsanto corn right up there and right over there in the distance. Okay? Which anyway, I'm not going to get into all that. So, you see the leaves here? I treated this before because we had insects on them, but I killed off the insects and they're coming back. Everything's coming back because I treat it with the water and baking soda for the disease. If it's got disease, insects, I use water and dishwashing liquid in a mix. It usually kills them off pretty rapidly, almost instantaneously. This is the green zucchini, the black beauty. We got a few off, huh? Now they're coming back. Everything's coming back. Cucumber, these are the cucumbers I planted. These seeds here, these two seeds right here I planted, they don't look like they're coming out as good, but they should. It's blurred, there it is. I put two seeds down there. You can see there's two plants. And I planted those two the same day. You can see those are a lot better looking, but these are okay, they're not dead. I was supposed to rain a few days, but I still might water these tomorrow morning. We've gotten a couple small pickles, if you would, off the cucumber. There's a helicopter up there. I want to see if I can get that or not on here. Oh, there goes my cane. I planted three peppers over here. It looks like they're growing. I put the seed right in the ground. Generally, the peppers and tomatoes you want to transplant out into the ground, but I put down three seeds, of which it looks like there's one there, one in the middle there, and that's either grass or that might be a pepper plant. I'm not sure. Can't tell it with this camera, but so. This is something I learned too. The east end of the garden, the sunflower fence, wind protector, whatever, this is nut garbage. I put a bunch of seeds all the way down, just like I did on the north and west end. Of course, the west end grows better than all the rest. Okay, right, and then that comes back around the north end. I planted some more beans down here because I wanted more beans. And I planted that one down there. Was it just recently? I planted one right here. It's only been about 2 days, maybe 3 days. These others I planted way too late. Too late. I planted them about the third week in April. And most beans, it seems like, and peas, you want to plant them in February, the end of February, second week of February, third week of February, and then let them grow in March and April into May, and you should have your beans. Not at the end of April, and then you got May, which was a hot month this year in the 90s most of the time, and then into June, which was another one. And you can see, here's the result of that, okay? Too hot, too soon. But then again, man, God's controlling the weather anyway, so it really wouldn't make much difference. It's a gambit, whatever you do. Plant them whenever you want. Take a guess. You know, you might grow some, you might not. You might eat, you might not. So you got to learn. I'm learning the hard way, but we got these other peas here, black-eyed peas, I know, and mixed in here, and purple hull peas right there. I think that's a black-eyed pea right there, that one there. Then there's four Mexican beans I planted right there. That one there is two, and right there is two. I planted something down there. I think I planted the Good Mother's Stollard. I planted two beans down there. From a previous video, you'll see. I'm not sure if this is the Triberius. I've planted Trail of Tears Cherokee Trail of Tears right down there. I put three down and all three of them came up. Seeds from Heirloom Solutions are 99% as far as I'm concerned, because when I planted one seed, one plant came up. I purposely, one of the few times I put down three. I would sometimes put down two if I wanted a little bushier, you know, a little longer, thicker vines. But because the beans are doing so poorly because I planted so late on the other types of beans, these won't grow good with the heat. So I put three down in my makeshift fences. This was just a 50-foot roll, 50 by 3 feet. I cut it in half, so I got 100 feet out of and 18 inches. And I think some of them got those little barbs down there. I'm messing with it. With my health and my knees, I can't do a lot of that stuff. So I just put tomato stakes through there and make my own little fences for them to crawl on. All of them? Okay. Alright, but watermelons are one of the first things I planted out here. Mr. Reasons gave us a few beans, big beans too, about the size of a quarter we put out here. And that's what these are. I planted them out so early, so late. No, what was it? Oh yeah, in April. And like I say, because of the heat and all that, that's where I had some right there. Here. I think I had it here too. And this is the result right here, because there were two down there, and there are two here, of which one of them is completely dead. The other one looks like it might still hang on. But my watermelon I planted the second week of the third week of March. See, that's one of the longer watermelons right there. Last year we had some big ones, 20 inches long watermelon. Couple more on here too, I believe. I can, but see, the crawlers, they latch onto the grass and you can't really move it without pulling it up by hand, so I can't really pull it out. I think my wife saw one more on there. I'm hoping the butterflies and bees get out here and start pollinating. They have done quite a bit. I was going back here, but this is a honeydew. I thought there was one on here. See you, right? right now. Like I said, I'm trying to look through the camera and trying to hold the camera and cane in one hand. And then I got a watermelon plant right there and one plant right there. And this one's got watermelons on them. Look at this one here. That's bigger than a golf ball. Bigger, much bigger. About 1.5 size golf ball. That right there is about the size of a 12-inch softball. You can see it right there. This one's about the size of a bowling ball. That's the first one and the biggest one that came out, of course. The biggest one, that's the first one. That's a sweet baby or a sugar baby. Well, I don't even see one down there. Let's see if I can get on the video here. Right there, it looked like a little pea. Not a pea, but there's another one right there, too. Come on, focus. Right in the middle of the screen. Right. I mean, where's my cane? Right there. Right there. Where's my cane again? Right there. And then I put okra back here too. One in the corner. Two, three, four. Seeing back here, the north wall, I guess you'd say, of sunflowers. This was to help block from the crap coming off the fields. Next year, I'm going closer to this high grass between where the sunflower fence is here. I'm going to go right in front of that right there, about 3 feet out. It's approximately 15 feet from the plastic garden. And go all the way down to that, and then go 15 feet out from the plastic that way and meet. So it'll be 15 feet away from the garden. Right now it's about 10 feet. And again, everything's going to be planted earlier because, like I said, it's a learning thing. Every year it's something a little different. I thought sunflowers would grow better. I really did. The west wall is the only one. You can see those, the tallest ones are the mammoth sunflowers. There's that one right up there. You know, the flower's up in the center up there. It hasn't quite opened yet, but it's opening. There were two of those. The wind knocked one down. Actually knocked one down. That's how strong the winds are out here. Because look at out in the distance. It's a total of 300 acres surrounding the house. And it's all Monsanto. All the poisons. And all the stuff that goes with it. But I'm doing the best I can with what I can. See, here's one here. This is almost as tall as me. It's just under my head. But these are from last year. I didn't plant these or anything. These are just from last year coming up. And I'm leaving them here. There's about 12, 15 of them. That's a mammoth right there. That's about 15 feet tall now. Right in the corner. I just started growing up and I told my wife, no, that's not cut down. I think that's a sunflower. And it is. It's a mammoth sunflower. It's about 15 feet tall. That'll have a big old head on it. Big old head on it. With a lot of seeds. And a lot of these are from seeds from last year's sunflowers. See, heirloom you can grow continuously over and over and over. You know, whereas you go to a lot of stores and you buy seeds, some and very few will grow the following season. Most won't. That's what Monsanto wants. You buy from them every year or you don't grow. So, we got tomatoes out here now. I got this leaf curl. I've been out here, I've picked off the brown leaf is a lot. There's still quite a few on here that's got brown leaf. This one I transplanted out here about a week and a half ago. It's doing good. This is this one right here. Focus. That one right there now was the one like I had last year. We had last year in the first garden. And it was about like this one here. But again, because the winds out here, these leaves are so about 85% of them, 80% of them are curled. But look how big this is spread out. I got strings on branches to hold them up. They're so big and heavy. Got tomatoes. I'm trying to keep them off the plastic. Plastic gets hot. Underneath the plastic is about 10 degrees hotter than it is on top, at least. So, and these things like heat. That one, two, three, three really good sized tomatoes. That one down there is a big tomato. That's about the, that's almost the size of a softball right there. And then there's your baseball size one, the middle one there. And then I might get that one today or tomorrow. Where's that? And then that one tomorrow, and that one, this one probably first, and then these two here tomorrow or the next day. I like to get me a green tomato too to fry too, because green tomatoes, anybody knows anything about green tomatoes. Yeah, see, this is another one I have to get string on this branch. These tomatoes aren't on the ground yet. They're right above it though. Here's my cane. Oh, I see, I can untie this one, untie this string here. Tie this string and go down here to about there and put underneath this and pull the branch up to keep those tomatoes up off the plastic. I'm gonna show you something. If you're in outside in the summertime, it's already flew off. It was a big horsefly or a deer fly. I'm talking about an inch and a half to 2 inches. The big flies, they're flies and they bite. You know, so I was gonna crush it. I don't like to hurt or kill animals like insects, but you know, if they're gonna hurt me or my wife, they're gonna die. Just like anybody tries to hurt me or my wife, they're gonna die. That's not a threat, that's a guarantee. See, this is a telltale sign of a worm, hornworm. All these, but see, it's because I'm pinching off these leaves. Like, see here, you see the spots on here? You gotta pinch that off so it don't spread. Gosh, and I don't know how much damage, if I'm doing any damage doing this even, but I'm cutting it off all the way off like that. It's got all these leaves on here that are bad. It's got one tomato on it right now. And there's one flower at least, one or two flowers. No, these are brown leaves too. See, I don't wanna touch the plant with the leaves I got in my hand. God bless it. See, I can't do it with one hand in the camera. But that's what I was doing, pinching off the bad leaves so that the plant can survive, and it will thrive generally. So, we got that little tomato plant right down there. Yeah, where is it at now? Right there. Got that one back there. It's all swiveled up looking again. The one I transplanted out here. So right now we have one, two, three, 4, 5, 6, 7, and there's one I brought back. It was completely dead, it looked like, and I kept watering it, putting the Epsom salt and sugar, and it's come back. So 8, so I'm gonna count that anyway. 9, 10, 11, 12 back there in the corner, and the one I transplanted, 13. Of the 13, that one there, I don't know if it's going to make it still through the summer, but 13 tomato plants. I wanted to have like 20, but we got the space out here for it on the plastic. Just got to get them in the house. We got 4 plants, but again, you know, it's late, already late. It's July 2nd, so if we get them, great. If not, well, like I said, we know again for next year what we need to try. Each year, it's a little different. But like okra last year, see, these are all over here, were about as high as that sunflower right there, the orange sunflower. Gosh, and the name escapes me now. Torch. The orange flowered ones are torch sunflowers. This gets monarch butterflies. Did you hear that? That was a hummingbird that just buzzed me, basically. Sounds like George Jetson from the Jetsons when they go by sometime. But the hummingbirds love it. We got a hummingbird feeder right there with sugar water. They love these flowers. See, there's a smaller butterfly on that one there. It's a small one. Usually, I've had the yellow and black and the blue and black. Maybe as July gets here, we'll see some monarchs out here, hopefully. We had them last year. We had about 4 or 5 monarchs out here, monarch butterflies. So we're just hoping that this will help attract more. That's another one right there. Doesn't have any flowers coming out yet. I got one by the corn. See, I tried sprinkling them all through the other sunflowers too. There's about 3 of them up there in the north wall. I mean the east wall. This is a torch right here. Right? See again. See how this is the grass. This is another thing that we have to keep looking at for next year, what we're going to do as far as in between these gardens. We're going to split the back one so it'll be two gardens, so we'll have four out here instead of three. Which the one I'm standing on is one and two over there, and then this left side will be three and over there four. Tomatoes will be moved a little further that way there. Like I say, we've been improvising for like the last 4 years, 3 to 4 years out here. Been here four and a half years. So if I can just get me three or four pumpkins off the vine right there, which there are a few of them growing, small, about the size of baseball, softballs. Get some pumpkin seeds. Oh, here's a sunflower right here. This is a mammoth sunflower. You can always look at the mammoth. You can tell because it's got the real thick, thicker than a broom handle usually, stem in the middle. My medicinal flowers I have out here. You see, now that's a perfect example. That helps attract the butterflies and all that too for the okra. I guess if I can get it now. Right there, see the flower on the okra? That's what they pollinate and all that. That helps you get those pods. I've already pulled off a couple this morning, gave one to Petey, and I've had some. You can eat them fresh off the vine, they're pretty good. Not really great tasting to a lot of people, but they're one of the most healthiest things you could eat is cutting a pod off of a okra plant and just chomp on it. Start eating it. And I got that sunflower by CJ's grave right there too. But there's a Hummer. Go up by the corn. Yeah, I see a lot of them over by the corn too. They hit those tassels and that helps fertilize the shucks of the corn. The gold, the yellow hairs that come out, each hair is a kernel of corn. And when they're supposed to be made together, the corn kind of tight together, which they are real tight, I think a little more tighter than they should be. But the wind just knocks all that pollen down there and it smells real sweet around those corn. But it knocks it onto the hairs of the cob and they turn a brownish color, and when they do, that means they've been fertilized. So anyway, the peppers are doing better. Nothing spectacular like they did the year before, but they're growing a little bit. You know, before they were all down, they just didn't seem like they were wanting to come up. But 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in the middle, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 pepper plants out here. And I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, almost 6 more I'd like to have, but you know, 10. And then those 3 I planted in garden number 2. So with the sun now, the sun keeps coming up a little bit further more on the western, out of the east, the northeastern sky. It's been coming up in that direction, and slowly coming over this way, and then eventually it'll come up right there. Right at the end of those trees, straight up over us. And this will have almost full sun, 85-90% of the time. And maybe they'll take off then too. So by the end of July, we'll see. By in the next 2 or 3 weeks, I'm going to have at least 8 ears of corn off of the corn. We're going to go out here and get some of my okra here later today. Get about maybe 12 or 15 pods of okra. Get one tomato, maybe two. And then tomorrow, the other one or two. So